So it's March 31st, 2020, and I do put this in my direction. I've moved that up in the stream that I walk up and down for a morning break. And the time for that is 7:43 a.m.
Okay.
What's your drama? What's drama, baby? Don't worry, if they make too much noise, I'm gonna do a video. Anyways, I'm recording, so every noise they make can be picked up.
Okay, mama.
Oh, no.
instant feedback on accuracy and time. Fun and addictive gameplay tracks your progress and keeps you motivated. Whether you're a complete beginner or an advanced professional, you can follow amazing expert design courses that guide.
Tyson, Mike, we've got an unbelievable, we've got the fucking man in here today.
Yeah, we've got a model in here.
We've got a demigod in here, man. Snoop Dogg. Thanks, brother.
The Godfather.
Hey, man, thank y'all. You know what a champ called the dog will answer. I'm
very grateful for that, man.
Because, man, you know how our relationship is. Mike, I love you like I love you, man. You know what I'm talking about? No explanation to it.
Well, shit, man, you guys have known each other a long time.
Uh-uh. Get off. Get off. Off. Get off of that. I'm gonna work up here, see you, and I'll be up here. I'm not gonna work out, baby.
And he was never too big. Like, that's what we loved about him, that he was never too big. He always seen us eye to eye. You know, when you're at the pinnacle of your career, sometimes you tend to look down on people. But he never looked down on us. He always looked at us eye to eye. It was a mutual respect, and that's the question we always had for him. That's why we love this business endeavor that he's doing now. We're happy to see him doing things, and, you know, expanding his brand and
where's
taking
Samantha?
His thing to another level because
where
he
did
worked
she
the
go?
All time next to
where's my baby? Where's
we
my baby?
Mike about a year ago, I couldn't believe the humility, how humble and
are
how
you serious, dude?
And how big your heart is, man. Seriously, dude.
I'm
nobody. I played 6 years in the NFL, man. I'm just another dude from
fucking
Valley,
baby.
And I got to beat Mike.
Baby.
This dude greets me with a hug. Well, Snoop, this is a special episode for us.
Come on now.
And it's actually going to be.
Do you need air conditioning here? Cause
a little toasty.
Yeah.
Well, you said you was hotboxing.
Yeah. Can we get some air?
That's the rule of hotboxing. You ain't got no air on. Enjoy the smoke. Might get used to it.
Okay, mommy has to. Let's hit this up, okay?
The round ain't over yet. The round is not over, champ.
Today, this episode is going to be brought to you by Post.
Yeah, well, that's why you asked was I hungry.
Yeah.
Well, if
you
got
a drink,
no,
you
I want some food.
Hell yeah, brother.
Give me some Roscoe, a cup
about.
Of chicken wine, some rice and gravy.
Down with Postmates, right?
Yeah. Hell yeah.
Yeah,
that's it.
Postmates are down with each other.
Okay, well, Postmates, I'm going to make an order right now. Go to Roscoe's, give me 5 wings, some macaroni and cheese, rice and gravy, cornbread, and a sunset drink.
All right.
And put a lot of ice in it, little ice cubes. Get it together.
Hey, Snoop, let's talk about the brother Nipsey. I never had the opportunity to meet him.
Man, Nipsey Hussle, man, that's my dear brother right there.
Oh,
Nipsey
bro.
Is a he's a South Central legend. He was a businessman. He was a leader, a teacher, a father, an entrepreneur. all of the above, and then the fact that he was an ex-gangman, you know. Yeah, he comes from a gang environment, but he rose, and then he built in his community. He bought property in his neighborhood. He actually owned a piece of his neighborhood. So he did things that a lot of ghetto superstars dream of, being from the neighborhood, being loved by the neighborhood, building in the neighborhood, and employing the neighborhood. So he did all of the above, and he was a young man that just really had a vision out of this world. So his legacy definitely will live on. You know, it's tragic that his death came at such an untimely, you know, time in this world, but we understand that when God calls on you, it's his time.
You know, he's, all I can say is this young man has so much love. I love for so many people. I don't even know him back before. I heard the name of him. The love that he's received.
Wow.
Since hearing of his death is frightening. It's just...
It's like a God, right?
Yeah.
I didn't even say
it. I'm going to say it. It's like a God, Mike, because we must know that we do walk among the gods, and we walk among the angels. But we need to know that, and we just found out that he was a descendant of Ali Asalasi.
I was telling my friend, he looks like him.
He's a first descendant of him.
Well, he looks like those guys, Etria.
That's what his nationality is.
Tell us about him.
The thousand bloodline.
Oh, wow.
The king of all kings.
Wow.
The triple crown. Walked with lions. Yeah, believe that. Gave Queen Elizabeth a lion. Sent her one back in the days. The only one with the triple crown. Ali Asalasi. Ja Rastafari.
So Nipsey smoked a lion.
Oh, yeah. Believe me. That was my dog. He has a wing called the Marathon. Right? So I used to call him all the time because he used to bring me over sacks. And I remember the last message I sent him, he didn't have none for me. So I'm like, don't have me pull up on you because I need some more of that marathon. I done ran out of my legs. Now I need some more marathon to get me to the next level. Because his weed was so good and it was called the Marathon. That was his whole push, was the Marathon. Everything he was supportive of was the Marathon. So it was like the marathon continues. And when you're smoking with him, it's like you're smoking in a marathon because it goes on and on and on.
Life is a marathon.
It really is.
Quick fight.
Pace yourself.
Not a quick fight.
Yeah, pace yourself. Shout out to Nipsey Hussle. Rest in peace. The marathon continues.
Much love.
I mean, shit, dude. Snoop.
I'm here, man. I'm here for y'all. And I like to talk about the Tyson Ranch that I just seen. You know, Mike, you've been put that under development for a little bit of time, and I can't wait for the world to see it.
Done in 2020, I believe.
Wow.
And it's going to be, to me, it's going to be high-tech, state-of-the-art. You know what I mean? In my opinion, eighth wonder of the weed world.
I believe that. It may be the second wonder of the weed world, because we don't have seven wonders of the weed world yet.
Oh, I forgot.
Yeah. We only got one wonder of the weed world.
You.
Thank you.
Hell yeah.
You.
Oh, it's good.
No, but to me, your ranch reminds me of like Disneyland or Disney World.
Yeah.
Something that, you know, is another level of entertainment, but it's catered towards the cannabis community. And at the same time, it's catered towards people like, you know, who want to just have a resort to get away, to have a great time, to relax themselves, to get away and just enjoy life. Like, you're building the perfect paradise. You're building heaven on earth.
I was explaining to some people when we had our first festival, so many different disenfranchised brothers unable to see each other for years, to meet each other for years, that, you know, people may think of stoners, or family think they're outsiders, and they had a chance all intertwined with one another. And that was just a beautiful view to watch before that Kind Festival.
I think the Kind Festival represents people. Like, so you definitely gonna have all kinds of people there, no matter what their background is or what their makeup is. Like, and you represent love, and I like what the motto said. What is it? Health. What's the three words you just said up there?
Be safe, be kind, be well.
Exactly. Yes. Right there. Be safe, be kind, and be well. That just sets the right spirit to know what you're coming into, to know what you want to be a part of. I'm down with it, Mike. I can't wait for you to ask me to perform that.
Get down.
How do those years feel? lived through that era.
You know what, Mike? To survive that era, I look back at it because I know how deadly it was, how life-threatening it was, and I just thank God I had the precision to believe in him, to let him, you know, guide me and put me on the path that I needed to be on.
You send so many freaking emails. Where did it go?